And when they see you praise God, that could be enough just to bring them out of what they're going through. Y'all might not realize that when Sister Rita is here, she's filming because people are watching you from all over the world. But how you know? Because I get calls from California, Texas, North Carolina, Arizona. I get calls from all over the United States with people that are going through something.
Amen.
But if they see you praising God,
amen,
you will begin to give them strength and let them know that God is a way, a way maker.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Don't fool yourself. Everybody is going through something.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Rich folks is going through something.
Yeah.
Poor folks is going through something.
Yeah.
Everybody is going through something.
Oh, yeah.
And that's the reason why you should praise God, because you're going through something.
Yeah.
Which means you're on your way out of something.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
See, the devil got that thing back, mother, when we're going through. He makes us want to sit down and be quiet.
Yeah.
He makes you want to hold your peace.
Yeah.
He makes you want to look sad.
Yeah.
But when you're going through, that's the time to praise God, because when you're going through it, you praise God, my God might take you through it a lot quicker. It's like coming through Memphis to get to Arkansas. If I put my feet on the paddle, if I go from 50 to 60, I might can move a little faster. That's what praising God do. When you praise God, God will take you through something a little faster. That's why the enemy mother don't want us to praise God when we come to church. He don't mind us coming to church, because guess what? He comes too. But he don't want you to get into the presence of God. Because he knows if you get into the presence of God, what happened last night won't even bother you no more. What folks said about you won't even bother you no more. That's why the scripture said, take your burden to the Lord and leave them there. Now you got God here. Why don't you just look at your neighbor and say, now since you're here, why don't you leave your burden here too? Glory to God. Y'all have the internet service and can see yourselves on the internet. If you just can see somebody that's going through, some struggling mother that's going through and don't know how she's going to make it, if you could picture her in your mind watching you right now, watching your face expressions, watching you praise God, you'll say, I'm going to praise God just for that mother that's going through. We don't know if she's in Dallas. We don't know if she's in Texas. We don't know if she's in Arkansas. We don't know if she's in California. But somebody right now is going through something much worse than we're going through. We ain't going through nothing compared to somebody else. You might be about able to get, you might be at the urge of getting your utilities off, but you ought to thank God for a roof over your head. Because somebody is sleeping up under the bridge. Some mother somewhere in this world is up under a bridge. Some fathers right now is up under a bridge going to the river trying to get fish and stuff to feed their family, and the devil make us look like we're the only somebody going through. We ain't going through nothing compared to somebody else. We're not going through nothing. I refuse to come to church and look sad. Act sad. David said, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Where your strength come from? Somebody give me a